I'm your host, Demetrius Andre. Whenever I'm done having a tremendous day working out and I need to get a deep sleep, I go to ZMA. And what this does is put you in a deep sleep, relaxation, and it's going to give you fast recovery at night.
Yo, Tevin.
What's up? How you doing?
These
dudes be petrified when I walk down on them. You see him trying to be my friend? Like, no, it's not friend zone right now. I'll be your friend after the fight if I feel like it.
So wait, what happened there, Tevin? What happened there?
He was popping shit on social media, so I seen him over there with the green hair, and I walked down on him, simple. And he tried to be my friend. No, we ain't going to be friends. He's like, hey, it's my... No, we ain't going to be friends. That's not what we do. When we teach somebody, if you pop and fly, it's how we do it in the streets. If you, it's not the streets, but it's similar because you disrespectful. If you popping, and if I see you, I'm going to come walk down on you, like, what's up? You know what I'm saying? You got to keep the same energy. The energy was different today. He started getting hype at the end, but the energy was different. He know. Yeah, and you see when his homie touched me, he got off me. Don't touch me.
So what caused all this?
Pop and fly.
But on social media, the whole...
Fly. Listen, it's one thing to call somebody out. It's one thing.
So
but
who called who out on social media?
I'm a champ. I ain't calling nobody out. It's one thing to... Yeah, it's one thing to call somebody out. I'm saying because everybody want what you got when you're a champ. That's one thing. But when you be disrespectful, that's a whole different outlook. When I see this other boy, if I ever see him, I'm gonna run down to him too.
Tell him about it.
How were they being disrespectful from your end?
I mean, just saying a little different shit. Just saying all types of stuff. I'm saying outside of boxing. Anytime you speak on something outside of boxing, I feel like it's disrespectful. So if we in the sport of boxing, that's just keep it boxing. That's keep it where it's at. Anything outside of boxing, then it's disrespect.
He said it in interviews this week that you're avoiding him, that you didn't want to fight him.
Okay, just say that. I'm avoiding.
What's your response to him?
I'm avoiding him. Say it. He said, go ahead. I'm avoiding him. Fuck out of here. He want that paycheck. That's what he want. When I was down and out, and I won't say I was broke, but I was broke compared to boxing money, and nobody wanted to give me a shot. Nobody gave me a time of the day. Nobody. Managers, promoters, nobody. And I grind my way up to get with the top promoters, and I manage myself, and I got a lot of business. I got business going on, and I grind so hard to get to this point. Now you dudes want to start calling me out, but none of y'all gave me a shot. Golden Boy ain't give me a fucking shot. I reached out to Golden Boy. I reached out to fucking Robert Diaz. I got fucking emails with him. All these dudes, nobody gave me a shot. You know what I'm saying? So now you motherfuckers want to pop fly and do all this. Come on, man. You ain't getting no shot. You're going to get a shot when I say you get a shot.
When do you think he will get the shot?
I don't know. Maybe never. Be number one. I had to fight for mandatory. I was in the rankings for a while. I had to fight to be mandatory because their favorite line was, "What do we gain from fighting Tevin Farmer?" Because I could fight. So they, we beat him. Then what? Now all of a sudden I get a belt. I'm gonna let these dudes starve like they let me starve. I was starving. I'm gonna let them starve.
In terms of one. Tank Davis,
become number one. What's up with Tank?
He brought him up, I believe, your trainer.
No.
Okay, it's your brother. Okay, his brother. Excuse me. That's another back and forth between you and him.
No, not no more. No, I fell back from that. The fight not happening. You know, I wanted the fight to happen. Davis said he wanted the fight to happen. For some reason, it's not happening. Me, Eddie, Lou DiBella always talk about this. And we'll go to Showtime if we had to fight him. But, I mean, it's not happening. So I'm not going to put no more energy into that. You know, like I said before, it's up-and-coming fighters that's gunning for my spot. It's fighters at my level that's gunning for my spot. So it's other fights to focus on right now besides focusing on that fight, you know. He's not going to make it break my career. I'm not going to make it break his career. So when that fight happened, it happened. I don't know when it's going to happen, but when it happened, period. So at this time, we're going to fight mandatories, and we're going to fight who we want to fight. We want to dictate how we want to do it. The same way these dudes dictated to me, I'm addicted to these dudes. So after my mandatory, we're going to fight what we want to fight. I'm going to talk to Eddie and Lou. We always on the same page. The respect between us is great. We respect each other. There's never no conflict in us, ever. We always on the same page. So after I beat my mandatory, we're going to go back and we're going to say who we want next. And we're going to decide who we want next, and we'll make the most sense, and we're going
to
fight them.
You mentioned that you could go to Showtime to fight Tank.
No, not I could. I would.
You would. Yeah. So with you saying you would go, you're willing to go.
Yeah,
why not get this next fight under the way, his fight that he's going to have in Baltimore out of the way, and go ahead and go into that fight?
Yeah, I mean, you know the business. Listen. This is the thing. Don't misinterpret what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Of course, I will go there. But it got to make sense. I don't want anybody to take this any other way. Oh, he said he'd go there and they offered me $1 million. You know what I'm saying? You gotta be willing to pay me what the Zone paying me. Man, Fat Night, what the Zone? You got to be willing to pay me more than what the Zone is paying me. Because I'm going to your platform, so you already have an advantage. So you got to be willing to pay me more than what the Zone paying me, not equal, more. I'm coming to your hometown. I'm pretty sure when Davis come over here, he's going to get paid more than me probably, you know? I don't know the business on the outside. I haven't talked to him, but I'm pretty sure because he's sacrificed. He's coming to the Zone. I'm sacrificing going there. So if I go there, pay me more. Pay me what I deserve. I'm a champ. I defended my belt 4 times. And I defended my belt more times than somebody had having the belt for 2 years. I did it in, what, 7-8 months. So
when is the next fight, the mandatory?
July. We're going to do July. Not sure on the date yet, but we're going to do it July. I'm going to talk to Eddie and Lutz next week after this. We're going to get past this weekend first. There's a lot of big fights here, and they got other business to do. So next week, we'll focus on that. We'll focus on me getting back in the ring.
What'd you make of the last fight that Tank had against the late minute replacement?
I mean, he did what he was supposed to do. To a small guy that's coming up from 122. I'm not 122, I'm sorry, 118. He did what he was supposed to do, and that's all you can ask for from a fighter. If you get put in there with a fighter, this dude is supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? I'm a fighter myself, so I'm not really big on criticizing fighters. He did what he's supposed to do. That's it.
With you in this division, once you get past the mandatory, is it a JoJo? Or is it somebody else with a belt?
He's going to starve.
Like, what's starve. You want him to starve yet?
He's going
to
starve. He's starving. I'm making it clear. He's starving. If Golden Boy paying a lot of money, then we can make it happen. But if not, he's starving. Go gun for Tank. Go gun for Ito. Go gun for Burchett. Go for one of them, man. I'm not giving these dudes no opportunity. These dudes ain't giving me no opportunity, and they're not happy for me. It's dudes that see me in the boxing business that see me come from nothing, had conversations with me, but because I'm not on their side, you're not happy for me. Like, that's just fucked up. Like, that's a fucked up individual. Like, it's beyond business when you see somebody grow from here to here. Like, it's beyond business. Like, all right, I don't care if you're on my side or his side. I like you. I'm supporting you to the end. Because we're not on the same size, you're not happy for me, so you don't support me. That's just a fucked up human being. It's way as a hater, as my boy. Yeah. So that's way beyond boxing. I'm saying being as a human being, sometimes it's way beyond business. Like, we have hearts. We have a heart, you know. And sometimes your heart take over more than business do. But when you're a human being, everything, every fucking second is about business, you're a effed up human being. And I'm all about helping people and inspiring. I'm starting a foundation in Africa, in Ethiopia, right now to help those kids get off the street and building a gym over there to help get them kids. And it's stuff that nobody know. You know what I'm saying?
So it's a lot of built up resentment from all that.
But that's why, like, I never met Floyd, and Floyd said some crazy stuff about me. Not bad, but some stuff. Like, I'm a $5,000 fighter and all that, but I'm way past that. I'm a seven-figure fighter now. But I understand the way Floyd feels nowadays, because, like, when you come from somewhere and people treat you a certain way, and when you get to a certain point, people expect certain things. So, and that's kind of how I feel. But, you know, I still got that good heart, so it won't let me let it out all the way. But when I get in front of the camera like this, I can speak how I feel.
Tevin, thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Thank you. Hold on, talk about. Yeah, and they go, so I got a YouTube channel.
Go ahead and plug it.
I started a YouTube channel. Life is Tevin Former, LIFEASAS, Tevin Former. Basically showing the world the life outside of boxing, you know, I'm real private. And I don't really show too much of me on social media. Only thing people really see is boxing highlights. But it's so more to Tevin Former. Like, I'm just a crazy, I just do all types of stuff. Fun thing, family man. I just do a lot of stuff. So I want everybody to tune into that, and I want them to see me outside of boxing, man. It's hilarious, man. I just want everybody to subscribe to the channel.